Hi, I'm Alexandra Bassett, and I'm the lead dog trainer and owner at Dog Savvy Los Angeles, a positive dog and puppy training company based in Los Angeles. And I'm here today with my foster rescue dog, Crackers, who needs some help learning how to self-regulate while walking on a leash. She gets very highly charged up when she sees people walking other dogs, critters in the environment. So I am walking her on a long leash today to do her very first BAT2O session. And BAT2O stands for Behavior Adjustment Training. And it's a desensitization and counter conditioning technique that helps a dog learn to self-regulate when there's very exciting or concerning things that they're encountering in the environment. So the goal is to give the dog more freedom on a longer leash, but keep far enough away from the triggers that the dog can habituate to them and start self-regulating rather than getting highly aroused or highly energized, which is what causes the leash reactivity on a shorter leash. So we're in an enriched environment, meaning we're in the park where there's lots of other things for Crackers to take an interest in besides the things that usually upset her or excite her. And the goal is to give her more freedom of choice on a longer leash so that we take the frustration that is often part of why a dog gets leash reactive, we take the frustration out of equation to give her more freedom to choose how the walk progresses and take some of the frustration out of the experience for her so that she can start to habituate to coming across all of these things rather than getting charged up when she sees them.
To get her muzzle off.
So as you're walking, the leash is about 15 to 20 feet long, depending on how comfortable you are with handling the dog on a long leash. And basically, wherever she wants to go within reason, I will follow her. Crackers is still getting used to her muzzle and will do anything to try to knock it off if she can. But as you can see, she's moving in curves. She's following her nose. And that's normally how a dog will explore the environment. So often when we put them on a short leash, it causes them some frustration or distress because they don't have agency, they don't have the freedom of choice to determine how the walk goes. And so that can create a lot of frustration for a dog who's being highly stimulated by things they come across in the environment. And so she was about to head towards what I would consider people triggers. And I don't want to walk her into hot water. So I brought her to a slow stop, meaning I just slowed her down gently. So I'm signaling to her that I'm not going to go in that direction by running my hands along the leash, which sends a vibration down the leash that the dog can actually feel. And I'm encouraging her to reroute before she goes over threshold. So part of that are leash handling techniques where you prevent the dog from going into what's called deep water where they're likely to go over threshold and enter into an arousal state. And the object of the training is to prevent that from happening at all costs. So I'm just stopping her and I'm waiting for her to choose a different direction. I don't want to head her towards these very exciting or concerning triggers that might prompt a guarding response from her. So I'm still waiting. I'm waiting for her to reroot. And I'm gonna just lean this way to see if that will signal to her to choose a different direction. And there she goes. So you can use body language more to help your dog choose a different direction. Now we're moving away from those triggers, and I'm just letting her explore the environment. And I am using specific leash handling skills. You have to imagine that you're kind of at the rodeo. So on one hand, you're controlling the slack in the leash. And only letting the slack out when the dog is going in the direction of somewhere that you feel confident about. Otherwise, you want to keep your dog on a shorter leash. But as she moves, if she's moving somewhere that I'm okay with her going with, I'll let out some of the slack of the leash. And this is just Cracker's MO. She loves rolling around in the grass. Right, Crackers? Up to the trigger. Feel like I'm walking in circles, but that's because dogs move more in a curve-like way when they're relaxed. They follow their nose. They don't move in a linear fashion like we do, because we're often very destination-oriented. We want to get from A to B. And dogs are more smelling the roses along the way. Stop her from drinking the dirty pond water, though. what I meant when I told you that there is this guardrail fence all along the perimeter of the park. So it really helps in controlling proximity to triggers. And often because it's really wet in the park in the morning, people aren't tromping through the park yet. So their feet will get all wet, so we tend to stick to this outside.
It is a bit hard to hear you in the set of the park because of the highway.
Sorry?
Just a heads up, it is a little hard to hear you in the set of the park because of the highway.
Oh, okay, yeah. I don't have a mic on. This is really just for the videographer to help me figure out how to film. That was good. She walked by the guy with Jeffrey.
Thank you.
dog off leash. Cocker has a muzzle on, so if for some reason the dog came running over here, I wouldn't be too stressed about it. But since they are kind of making their way in this general direction, I'm going to reroute with Crackers. Crackers! I'm going to call her. Good girl. Plummets when she has the muzzle on. She's been working on it, but she's really less responsive when she has the muzzle on. She's still getting used to it. But because the trigger is over there, I'm rerouting her away when there's enough distance that I can control a little bit how the walk goes. We try to stay out of the process as much as possible. Possible, but you are also steering your dog away from trouble. If you think that they can't handle something.
Actually rewarding her in that instance.